The COVID-19 global restrictions came with a silver lining to the software industry, which saw growth of software applications like Zoom, Webinar, and Instacart. However, software developers in Uganda are cursing the high costs of internet for frustrating their growth at this opportune time when the industry should be taking off. Michael Nitegeka, the program director of Ray Factory, a software development skilling and training program, asks government to change its taxation approach on internet and treat it as a necessity.
It is important that government begins to see IT and specifically internet as an enabler and not as a luxury. Because the way we tax internet now, we tax it as a luxury. Now, if you begin to see internet as a productivity tool, your mindset on how you tax it changes. So government needs to see internet as a productivity tool.
Baker Sentamu, a software engineer, says the government has not given the industry the attention it deserves, as many contracts are given foreign firms, yet there is enough local capacity to compete. He urged the public and government to trust local software engineers with contracts in order to grow the sector.
The industry is still young and many people haven't yet learned the real workflows of producing software. And then also as homegrown software engineers at the moment, people find it hard to trust us. So we see government projects, they still outsource from those developed countries. But I believe it will change soon, because it's also on us to demonstrate that we have the ability to produce world-class software.
Many software innovations which would make life better lack financial resources to grow to a wider commercial scale. Speaking at the event of passing out of over 350 youth who have been trained in software development at Ray Factory, the executive director of NIRA, Rose Chisembo, called on government to enact new policies that favor young technology innovators thrive.
We are in an environment that is a rich ground for providing solutions that are software based. Think about it. We have people in Kampala who have farms. They don't know what is happening for them at their farms. Where are the dashboards, the solutions that can allow someone to work here and keep track with their farm or with their other business, that can connect to their cameras, that can connect their invoicing systems, that can connect to the number of guests coming in? Where are they? So we are in a very ripe environment for solution development.
Chisembo urged software innovators to come up with applications that can help NIRA to develop electronic identity cards and also establish systems of quick interaction and feedback from the public over ID issues.
With the open technologies, the only tool you need is a computer. Otherwise, GitHub will be your server, your code repository. So in this sense, the infrastructure has been, some other developer has made it easy.
Dr. Rose Nanyonga, the Vice Chancellor of Clark International University, which hosts the Refactory program, called for partnership from government to develop the software industry to reach out to more youths and address the problem of unemployment.
The government can see that we have piloted a program. We've consolidated that pilot, and it can be actually replicated in other places. And I think that's where the policy makers and the government investment can come in, because we are quite small. But you know, to be able to take the program to other parts of the country, for example, we do need partners from the government to be able to scale it. And I know that the program meets a need for the country. We have a lot of unemployed youth.
Story by Fred Kajubi for the news.